Chairman, all dignitaries and dear friends. India is the fastest growing economy, and I am confident that in due course of time, we are definitely going to increase the growth rate. As far as my ministry is concerned, the most important subject which is related to your heart about development of infrastructure. Without infrastructure, it is difficult for the country to achieve the appropriate growth rate. As far as the road sector is concerned, it is now a success story. The first time our government, under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, we have started the work of express highway, access control express highway. We have already completed the access control express highway of Delhi, which we are expecting reducing the pollution of Delhi at least more than 60%. Now the people coming from Punjab, Haryana, Kashmir, Uttarakhand, Himachal, and going to Maharashtra, Gujarat, anywhere, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, they don't need to come to Delhi. Directly by ring road, they can go to the states. As far as express highway is concerned, we are now going to start the express highway between Bangalore and Chennai. January, we are going to start this express highway. We are also making the express highway for Mumbai to Delhi, which is very important for the trade and business. This express highway is going to shorten the green alignment, is going to reduce the distance between Delhi to Mumbai by 120 kilometers. It starts from Gurgaon, going to Jaipur Ring Road, then going to Alwar, Sawai Madhopur, then going to in Madhya Pradesh, going to Gujarat, and then Vadodara, and then it goes to Mumbai. So this is 12-lane express highway, out of which Mumbai-Vadodara express highway, already we have awarded the work more than 44,000 crores. The next month, we are going to award the work between Gurgaon to Jaipur. And this express highway is very important as far as the trade and business of Delhi is concerned. Because this express highway is in the backward area of Rajasthan, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, and Maharashtra. This is a new alignment. Actually, I am telling you the success story of this express highway. We have reduced the cost of land acquisition by 16,000 crore. Existing Delhi-Mumbai highway is coming to Surat and Ahmedabad, and parallel to that, the land acquisition cost coming to 7.5 crore per kilometer. But in this highway, it comes to 80 lakhs rupees per kilometer because it is from the backward area of Rajasthan, all the Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Haryana, and Rajasthan. So that's the reason that we save the 16,000 crores on land acquisition. But now it is a great opportunity for all of you, for your industry, for your trade and business. The land acquisition cost is very less. The labor cost is less. This is the very nearer to Delhi. And here you can develop your industry. The logistic point of view also, this is very important. And I will request you to concentrate on your all efforts to take a special session that how you can develop your industry in the side of this highway. We are developing, we have a 120 meter of width is available. Even we can offer to railway to start bullet train from this road. Our land acquisition is as long as is now, we are going to complete it. So there is no problem about the land acquisition. So this can be a golden opportunity. Regarding the road sector, we have now next March, we are expecting 40 kilometers per day. So the road sector is progressing. The most important thing which I will appeal you about waterways. Here I need your cooperation, and what I am presenting you is economically viable. We have started the waterways from Varanasi to Haldia. We are maintaining 3 meters of draft. And for this year, we are expecting the transport of 80 lakh ton. And the next year, it is 280 lakh ton. It is very economically viable. Actually, as far as going through the road, the cost is suppose, for example, 10 rupees. Going by railway is 6 rupees. and going by waterways is only 1 rupees. And we want to use methanol as a fuel or a LNG as a fuel. That is again going to reduce the cost. So the logistic cost is the most important thing as far as the Indian trade and business is concerned. The cost in the export, we have a big problem because our logistic cost is 16% to 18%. In China, it is 8% to 10%. In the Western countries, European countries, is 12%. Girgaon or anywhere from the part of the Mumbai up to the new airport. So these are the new avenues, new opportunities which are available. And certainly there is 100% economic viability is there. We have taken a decision to convert 111 rivers into waterways. Already in 11 rivers, work has already started. And there is a good economic viability is there. We have taken RoRo services in many places where the one side, it is very economically viable and it is useful for the common people. In Ganga, we have 9 spots out of 2 already we have started. In Brahmaputra, we have got 8 spots for RoRo and RoPax. In Mumbai also, we have next month we are going to start from Bhautra Dhaka to Mandvi and Neral, where the people who want to go to Goa, they directly South Mumbai come to the RoRo service with their car or bus or truck, and within 15 minutes they can reach to Mandva. And we have constructed, we have already planned to construct a highway from Alibag to Wadkhal Naka on Mumbai Goa road. So the distance from South Mumbai to Wadkhal, it takes now for the car 2.5 hours or 3 hours, but it will be now 40 minutes with your own car. You can go up to Mumbai to Goa. So these are the new opportunities which are available. The new thing which is already we have started and which is very important for the Indian transport, that we have signed our WAPCOS is a company, government company with my department. I am also Minister for Water Resources. And the WAPCOS has signed the agreement with the Doffelmayr, which is from Austria, having a technical ability for ropeway, cable car, funicular railway, and they have 60% share in the world market. So in Himachal, Uttarakhand, in the Northeast, now everywhere, the lot of tourist spot where we can make the ropeway, cable car, and funicular railway. Here is the potential is available. The WAPCOS is already in discussion with the Kashmir Minister, Kashmir State, Jammu Kashmir, then Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh. Lot of good proposals which are economically viable. And this can be a sector where we can launch public transport on electricity. Because the capital cost for metro is for per kilometer is 350 crores. And for this, even it is less than 50 crores. Even in Delhi also, we are planning for making it from Dhola Kua to Manesar. Some of the new technology which this company has already launched in Philippines, where double-decker bus, having the air bus, which is of capacity of 250 people, they can take it from air. So this type of new, innovative, successful technology for public transport and electricity is our future. As my ministry also, we are working fast on converting our automobile into electric, ethanol, methanol, biodiesel, and bio-CNG. Because we have import of 7 lakh crores of crude oil. We need import substitute, cost-effective, pollution-free, and indigenous. Here is also a good economic viability is there. Today, it is a great pleasure for me. The Indian automobile manufacturers are fastly diverting their manufacturing to electric. Now, ethanol is a fuel from agriculture. We have a big capacities available for making ethanol, first generation ethanol from molasses, second from sugarcane juice, BAB molasses, third from ethanol from biomass, cotton straw, wheat straw, rice straw. Even we can use any type of biomass for making ethanol. Even municipal waste, we can use it, segregated municipal waste, organic waste for ethanol. So ethanol, and even we can make methanol from coal. These are the new successful technology innovations are available. We have already finalized all standards and norms for that. Even we are now going to convert our shipping totally into methanol. We are also starting this procedure. So these are the field where the huge potential is available. And as far as my feelings and economic viability is concerned, I will appeal all of you to invest in waterways, invest in alternative energy, invest in infrastructure. Regarding the Water Resources Ministry, It is also a very interesting story. There is also, we are expecting the huge investment. The river connectivity, Nadi Jod Prakalpa of Bajpayee, there was 30 projects. Now we add 5 more projects in it, out of which 6 projects already we have finalized, costing 3 lakh crore. And where our idea is, the water which is going to the sea, we can save that. Now we are already started the work in Andhra Pradesh in a big project named as Polavaram. The project cost is 60,000 crore, where the project is already 45-50% project is completed. Now backwater of Godavari available in Polavaram, we are taking this water to the Krishna, Krishna water to Penar, and Penar to Kaveri, by which our idea is to give, at least increase the save the water which is going to the sea from Godavari at least by 600 to 700 TMC. Now the dispute between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu is only for 45 TMC. So by this project, I am confident that we are going to resolve the water problem of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. So also there is a 2 project between Gujarat and Maharashtra. One is Daman Ganga and Pinjar. Other is Tapi Nar Narmada. And the third important project is very important to Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. That is Ken Betwa. So this river connective project, we have planning to having expecting the investment of 3 lakh crores. So I feel that in Sagarmala, we are expecting the investment of 16 lakh crore, out of which 4 lakh crores work already we have started. In the road sector, we have already awarded the contracts more than 10 lakh crores. By Bharatmala, we are going to start the projects more than 7,50,000 crores. As far as my ministry is concerned, we don't have our economic resources problem are not there, because we have a lot of money is available in our projects. We have just monetized our first bundle, where we are expecting 5,600 crore, but the Australian company quote, we get 150% more. It is with 10,400 crore. So in the capital market also, we have good response. There is no problem as far as the resources are concerned. The infrastructure, we are moving fast. But my request is regarding this water transport, regarding development of tourism, regarding development of ports. Now, the first time in the history of India, the private sector port in NCLT, where the JNPT, the government company is quoting for that, we are given a highest offer. So our all ports are in good profits. We have profits more than 7,000 crores. Our shipping is very important. We are developing 20,000 kilometers of waterways. We are now giving priority for development of cruise tourism. These are the new subject, and alternative fuel is also very important. I'm not telling you only to invest in this project, but you believe me, these are all economically viable projects. The good economics is there, and that is the reason that these are the more important sector for the country. And I feel that the projects are economically viable. And we want to develop water transport. I always, this is a very close subject to my heart, and I always appeal to the all of you. Now we are interested to start seaplane, MPBS seaplane. Now we have already finalized all rules and regulations. If anyone of you is interested to invest in it, it's really economically viable. And thousands of lakes and projects, these are available. So this is a sector also that you can invest in seaplane. It's a really a attractive proposal for investment with economic viability. I am also planning to start in 26th January a pilot project taking, we have some special technology from Russian company, that is the airboat. They are using, they say it's a mixture, that is the propeller is from aviation, the engine is from automobile, and boat is on the water, airboat. They are using the Land Cruiser engine from Toyota, and the Toyota, the Land Cruiser capacity for 6 people, but this boat capacity is for 16 people. The speed is 80 kilometer per hour. They need only 10 centimeter of draft. So now from Yamuna, from Delhi, our plan is to taking up to the Taj Mahal. So it can be only 1 hour journey with the Yamuna. And my request to all of you that invest in this innovative, successful practices. These are the new good business where the economic viability is available. And I feel that it can be really a good attractive proposal for all of you. It is always a pleasure for me to meet all of you, because the investor's role is very important. Because if we get investment, we will eradicate the poverty and create more employment potential. The economic growth is very important. As a water resources minister, this is very important response for me, that I am giving my priority to agriculture irrigation. We are spending 1 lakh crores on completing the incomplete irrigation project. Our idea is to convert at least 1 crore 88 lakh hectare of land into irrigation using drip irrigation. So lot of new projects we have already taken. We are resolving the issue between the states. Already for Delhi, we have taken 6 projects, 3 in Uttarakhand and 3 in Himachal, by which we are going to increase the capacity of Yamuna by 160%, and we will resolve the all water issue related with the Delhi. So at the same time, the last subject where I want to appeal you about Ganga. In Ganga, we have 280 projects, out of which 10% or 10 to 15% project we have already completed. Now 58 places where we take the sample of Ganga, now it is to be up to the mark. Now we are making 130 biodigester, majority work have already started. 12 projects, already we are doing many projects in 40 tributaries and nalas related with the Ganga. We are doing 11 projects in Delhi. At 27th December, we are going to start the project in Okhla also. There's a big function with the state government now. And also we are going to improve the water pollution in Delhi. The pollution, water pollution and air pollution is a big task, big problem. And we are concentrating and giving priority for that. My feeling is Ganga is now become a success story. Before March end, I am already declared that we will give 70 to 80% Ganga will be clean. And next March, it will be 100% clean. We are working on war footing on Ganga, where I am also, we need cooperation from you, that our Clean Ganga mission, where people are donating lot of donation for Clean Ganga mission, if you can give by electronic transfer, you can deposit your donation in Clean Ganga mission, it will really a great pleasure for me, and it will be a great contribution from all of you for Ganga. Even we are also starting work in Yamuna, lot of nalas are there, and here is also a good potential. So we are now planning starting work of 26,000 crore in Ganga, out of which 20,000 crores project already we have started. Some of the projects are in Bengal, Jharkhand, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, Haryana, and some of the projects are even in the states where the, in some of the, in Madhya Pradesh also, and where the tributaries of Ganga are there. So really, these are the very success story, and we need cooperation from you. Always it's a pleasure and satisfaction for me to discuss all of with you. It's really unfortunate that because of my health problem, I'm not in Delhi. But Monday, I'm coming to Delhi. That's the reason that I am not participating in your conference. I'm giving my all best wishes to your conference. And we need your great investment for the development of this country. Our Prime Minister's dream is of 21st century's New India, which is really full of technology, innovation, entrepreneurship, and research. And that is the need, by using information technology, biotechnology, and the investment of the, particularly the Indian investors are very important for us, because we want to create more employment potential, increase the growth rate, not only in this manufacturing sector, but also we are trying our level best to increase the growth rate in agriculture. If the purchasing power in agriculture is increased, it is going to helpful for all of you for your good business. Thank you very much. Namaskar.